All right, my name is Maureen Ryan, and I'm also a part of the Minion Group, and today I'm going to be talking to you a little bit about agricultural engineering. To get started, by a show of hands, how many of you enjoy eating? Yes, that's exactly what I figured. Well, consider how you would feel if your food supply was cut in half. Although this is a seemingly extreme situation, this could potentially happen in the near future. As the population continues to grow, our food supply and the land that we use to grow it, we don't have any more to use. So this is where agricultural engineering becomes extremely important, because it's allowing us to figure out how to use the land that we have to suffice for the growing population's need for food. So today I'm going to discuss a little bit about what agricultural engineering is and what they do, and how we can use agricultural engineering to create sustainable farming methods to be able to feed the growing population. So just a quick overview, we're going to talk about the engineering behind agriculture. Although it just seems like it's farming, there's actually a lot of science that goes into it, and it's really an advanced field. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about what engineers can do in the workplace to help out with agriculture and the significance behind sustainable farming. So the roots of agricultural engineering, it's definitely a combination of mechanical, genetic, and chemical engineering. According to Monsanto's article, A Brief History of Agriculture, the beginning of agriculture can be defined as when we stopped chasing our food and started growing it. So that seems extremely obvious, but what's important to notice is that we've been engineering agricultural and farming since the beginning of time. If you consider what corn used to look like compared to what our corn looks like today, it's changed a whole bunch, and that's just due to humans figuring out what works the best and what's the most sustainable option to continue feeding us. And then agricultural engineering has definitely advanced. Three things that are really important with it are sustainable agricultural breeding and biotechnology. So sustainable agriculture is kind of what I was talking about before. It's just about finding what works best and what can continue to work best to the future, so we don't use up all of our land too quickly and we don't use up all of our resources. Breeding is just kind of crossing plants together, like we all learned in genetics probably back in grade school, finding the best qualities of each plant, combining it to be able to create something that can really sustain itself towards like rain and drought and all those different environmental factors. And then biotechnology, that's more of a newer discipline, and I realize that it is slightly debatable with all of the genetically modified organisms. It could go either way, but I'm just here to let you know about how agricultural engineering is using biotechnology in order to change the genetic makeup of individual seeds for plants to be able to grow plants that are more beneficial to us as society. And then just in general, what an agricultural engineer does. So according to the Department of Bureau of Statistics website, the agricultural engineer discipline is just really focusing on sustainable farming and analyzing agricultural operations. So that can vary from many different companies, many different fields. Just to name a few different companies that might employ an agricultural engineer, you could use Caterpillar, Conagra Foods, Monsanto, and even the Food and Drug Administration definitely benefits from agricultural engineers. And it just, since it's a combination of many disciplines, they can work more like I said, for Caterpillar, they really focus on the mechanical engineering side of things. And as you see that picture in the bottom of the large machinery that they use out in the fields, so they can create better machines that can help us farm. For example, the seed drill, that helps us plant seeds spaced far enough apart that they don't choke each other out as they grow, but not spaced too far apart so that we're wasting our space. So they're really just focusing on how we can efficiently use the land. And that's more of like what organizations like Caterpillar would do. But if we're going to talk about like Monsanto, that would be the picture in the top middle. That machine is actually a seed chipper machine. So that takes individual seeds and scrapes off a tiny bit of it, so then they can analyze the genetics behind it to figure out what genes they can use to modify it in order to make it better for our future. They've actually had quite a few breakthroughs. They're eliminating the use of pesticides by putting a gene into the seed that allows it to just ward off the pests by itself without having to spray all those pollutants onto our plants and animals. And it's just really helpful for our future because it'll cut down on our pollution and let us to farm more sustainably and eco-friendly. And then just in general, why it matters. This is what I've been kind of talking about this whole time, but definitely agricultural engineering is super vital to our society today because, like I said, agriculture takes up 60% of Earth's arable land and 70% of our fresh water. And for a variety of other reasons, we cannot just use the 40% of extra land for farming and the extra percentage of water for farming because we live on it and some of it's just unusable, like deserts and such as that. we just can't use it. So we need to figure out a better way to use the land that we have and the resources that we have to feed the growing population. In the next few decades, the population is expected to grow by 75 million. So that's a huge number. And if we all enjoy eating, like I said at the beginning, we definitely need to focus on how we can improve our farming methods in order to continue eating, in order to continue sustaining the population as we grow. And as our society just continues to advance with other types of technology, as we all know, the iPhone X just came out over the weekend. We're super advanced in our technology methods, that I think it's really important that we can also use that technology and all of our different advancements for farming, so we can actually help ourselves with sustaining ourselves before we just continue in other technological advancements. So agricultural engineering is definitely super vital for our society today, and I just want you to think about how your life might change without it, and how important it is as we continue into the future. So thank you. Ooh.